Okay, but the thing is that I want to enjoy the freedom of the artist. In, at least in a democracy, the artist is free to express, should be, ought to be free, I know, to express his or her or their viewpoints, their ideas.
What world are you living in, George?
I hear you. I hear you, R.H. I know. There are lots of conditions on what we can say and what we can do. Nevertheless, there are even more if one is a politician. You've got to appease, and you've got to please more people. As an artist, I don't necessarily have to appease anybody. I want to please an audience. I want to please people. I don't have to appease anyone. And if I feel I've got to appease somebody, I should just get out of it. There's nobody out there I need to appease.
Those who appease make the biggest fortunes and have the biggest films. Those who don't appease work in very small theaters and are paid.
We're in cahoots, right?
We're in cahoots.
Absolutely.
I mean, there's a small price for independence.
There is.
There's a big price for independence. That's usually obscurity and poverty. But you're right. It is the place, the independent arts or the vital arts are actually where the fermentation and the creativity comes from. The power in the arts, the people on the top with the networks and the Netflixes and the whatever, who use the creativity to expand their financial empires and make a lot of money. I've seen that. But I'm also curious about your students, because the students that I see, the young actors that I see turning up on television sets, have been suppressed. Their creativity has been shrunk. Their expectations of what they can create as an actor or designer or a writer has been shrunk, depressed, whatever, because we don't do that on TV. We don't say that on TV. We don't tell stories like that on TV. All that, not on TV. In fact, has retrained the impulses of the young actors, directors, composers to kind of sentence themselves to being in this very small creative space. And it's driving me crazy.
You are absolutely right. You're absolutely right.
So there's no freedom in the arts.
But there is. So long as, and you know, I'm not trying to be prescriptive for anyone or anything, but I come back, my base also is history. I orient myself around a particular understanding of history, whatever it is that I'm going to do or try to do.